and I'll be right here after with the bands, getting the inside scoop and the latest info you need to know. All right, so I'm here with our first band of the night. What music do you like to listen to?
I like just about a little bit of everything. Like, I listen to old school, classic, that kind of stuff. But recently I've been into kind of the genre I'd say is defined as post-hardcore kind of deal. Like, I mean, a little bit of singing, a little bit of screaming, just something that's like raw emotion, that kind
of
stuff.
I like a lot of old metal and new metal. Like, I listen to a lot of Limp Bizkit, which isn't around anymore, and old metal like Slayer, and everything in between.
I listen to just about everything from Miley Cyrus up to Slipknot, just about.
I'll listen to about everything, but I'm mainly a metalhead, definitely because that genre of music allows me to more so express myself.
And what inspired you guys to join a band?
That's kind of a broad question, but I'd probably say just about all the music I listen to. Yeah. I don't know. I go to shows frequently, like I'd say like once a month, that kind of deal maybe. But I mean, I just go there and I lose myself in like the audience and the mosh and all that stuff, because I mean, it's not really about the music when you're there. It's more about all the people around you, because it's kind of like this unspoken bond you have with everybody. Because I mean, you're all there for the same reason, whether like you're hurt, you're broken, etc., even though those are both synonyms. But yeah, that kind of deal.
He kind of said it for me. I mean, you go to concerts and you get this vibe that the band gives you, your favorite band. And I think everybody kind of wants to give someone else that vibe. So that's the reason why I joined. I wanted someone to hear our music and just kind of vibe to it and connect, you know?
I pretty much grew up into it. My dad was always in a band whenever I was around. And he would let me get on the drum kit before him and his band would perform, and I would be awesome, they'd say. And, yeah.
I started playing music at a pretty young age, age 7. I'm 16 now. My first performance was at around 10. I kind of was inspired to be in a band at around that time because I wanted to have that unspoken bond with fans. It just really continued to escalate, and here I am now.
And what are some of your musical influences?
Depends. I'd say, I mean, I used to sing and stuff. I used to like try and like copy like old school metal, that kind of, yeah, Pantera. That's definitely, Chris knows, because me and him used to be a band before this and we played Cowboys from Hell. That song was definitely one of my favorites to sing, because really it's not even a technique. You just belt it out. It's just like anger. You're just pissed off. But for bass, I'd say, not really sure. I listen to like the post-hardcore stuff. I like the really heavy, like, chugga-chugga stuff. I like breakdowns and that kind of stuff. I go wild to that kind of business.
My influence, I'd say, I started drums in, like, third grade, fourth grade, and my favorite band was Avenged Sevenfold. And when their drummer died, I decided I wanted to try to carry on an unspoken legacy, not try to be him, but kind of do what he did and see if I can make the same connection he did with fans through his drumming skills, and just having everybody kind of, you know, look at a band like that and just, you know, such a drumming influenced, and everyone kind of does their own thing with their instrument. It's not just all about a singer. That being said, I mean, bands like Pantera that do stuff like that, Metallica, all that kind of stuff is good influence.
I would have to say Metallica or Iron Maiden. I would always go to a show anywhere around the country with my dad, and we would have a bunch of fun moshing and everything.
For me, as a vocalist and guitarist, I'd say I'm definitely more influenced by a lot of shredding metal bands, such as Killswitch Engage, Slipknot. Really that in-depth, heavy, emotional stuff. I can really relate to that. And in a way, it also helps me relate to people who I play for. So I'm most influenced by that.
All right. Our first band is Bunker Hill. They're from Haverhill High, Newburyport High, Whittier Tech, and New England Academy. They have some up-and-coming new demos that they're really excited about. They're a metal band, and about a year ago they started. They're relatively new, but they're super awesome people. So.
Oh, you're so sweet. Thank you. She doesn't even know
it
since she complimented us. That's how
cool
we are, man.
So, without further ado, I give you Bunker Hill.
What's up, guys? Man, that's nothing. That's nothing. That's wimpy. How are you all doing today? Much better. Much better.
I just hate it when people give quick responses like that. I'm sorry. This next song is a song called One Step Left. It's another original.
I'm here with our second band of the night, Veader. Veader? Right? All right.
Her last name is Veader, but that's stupid, so we call it Veader.
I agree.
That is cool.
All right, radical. All right, what music do you guys like to listen to?
No, I like classic rock, like Rush and stuff.
I like alternative rock, kind of.
Everything from punk to not punk.
I hate music.
All right. What inspired you guys to become a band?
Just wanted to kind of make music, I guess.
Yeah, but she said yeah.
Well, Richie's mother told me they needed a bassist, so I got the hookup.
That is, that's
from
exactly
Mrs.
what happened, too. That's the funny part.
Yeah.
All right. Have you guys ever performed in public before? When and where?
No, this is our first band performance, actually.
I have performed in public.
I performed
other places, but...
Yeah, same. No. It was a disaster.
This was the first band thing.
Okay. And what are some of your musical influences?
No, I'm thinking like Geddy Lee and like Robert Plant.
The Replacements, Paul Westerberg, Big Star, stuff like that.
Influences in bass range from punks like Mike Dirnt, what's his name, John Entwistle, all the great bassists. Yeah.
I record myself and then listen back and I influence myself.
Do what you gotta do. And finally, how long have you guys been together as a band?
We've been since like December.
I don't know why I thought that'd be different for all of you.
So this is Veader. They started in December. Ashley started this. She's right here. She started stalking them on Instagram. And she was like, hey, let's start a band together. And then they were like, cool. And so this is them.
Oh, yeah, we're Veader. And we're going to play She by Green Day first.
Yeah.
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 dude, I brought something. Hold on.
What else?
Are you long out?
Don't worry about it, it'll be perfect.
All right, I'm here with our next band. All right, I'm going to start out with our first question. What music do you guys like to listen to?
Oh, you know, the regular stuff that a 12-year-old girl listens to. You know, Twisted Sister, AC/DC, Kelly Clarkson.
I know the band played rock music, but I really prefer jazz. I mean, yeah.
I listen to AC/DC, Led Zeppelin, and the older blues stuff, like Robert Johnson.
Yeah, here you go, drummer.
I'm mostly everything except, like, classical music. I like it, but I just mostly like everything.
Personally, I'm more of a classic rock kind of jazz guy. Yeah, mostly play classic rock like we do in the band. Some metal's pretty good, but overall, probably classic rock.
And what inspired you guys to join a band?
Oh, well, Noah and I were friends from Stone Ridge. Yeah, like from school. Yeah, we were friends from school, and they needed a singer. He was already in the band, so I was asked to join, so I joined.
So the actual band was joined from a music school in Beverly. What?
It was. Oh,
Was joined from. Was formed by a music school in Beverly. That's yeah. It's called the Family School of Music. That's all I know about it.
So at the Fabulous School of Music in Beverly, they have a program called Rock Ensemble, and we have a director who we meet up every Friday night, and we rehearse, and we go play shows, and he gets us into like bars and go to parties and play out a lot. So it's a really good experience, and that's really how the band started.
And how long have you guys been together as a band?
We've been a band for about 3 years now. So, I mean, we've been together. It started out me, Noah, and Matt over here, and then eventually Jake joined, and then Juliet came in, and that's how we came together.
And finally, what are some of your musical influences?
Twisted Sister, AC/DC, right, yeah. Poison, Kelly Clarkson.
Anything that you'd expect a classic rock band member to listen to, that's me.
Jack White of the White Stripes, Robert Johnson, who's dead now, The Doors, all that good stuff.
Neil Peart, stuff like that, drummers, many other bands.
I definitely have to say Alex Lifeson is number one for me. And, you know, AC/DC, you have Metallica's good. I like, yeah, Rush, like Alex Lifeson, yeah.
They started about 3 years ago. Their ages they vary from 12 to 17, so that's pretty awesome. They go out to all these different gigs, and it's really cool. And they're from Topsfield. And they go all around. So let's give them a big hand.
Oh, and the truth is we'll be right back.
All right, I'm here with our next band. The first question is, what music do you guys like to listen to?
Well, I mean, I like classic rock, and, you know, I like some modern stuff too, like Green Day.
I mean, same thing. It's basically classic rock, 80s metal, punk. I have a big variety.
I'll listen to just about anything as long as it's good and it's fun.
I like rock music as well, as along with psychedelic rock music.
I'm kind of with Jeremy. I'll listen to just about anything so long as it sounds good.
All right. And what inspired you guys to join a band?
One day at lunch, I was like, hey, I like bands. Why not be in one?
And I don't know the exact story what made us get into the band. It's like, I don't know.
They needed a drummer, so I was like, okay.
Well, actually, I just, like, popped in. They were going to have a band.
You're the newest member.
Yeah. They were going to have a band, and I was like, oh, I want to join. And you guys don't have a bass player, so I'll be your bass player. And they were like, okay, cool. So that's pretty much the story of us.
As I recall, there was a battle of the bands at school freshman year. And it was a little bit before that, but I think that was what really caused us and tied us together.
And how long have you guys been together as a band?
Forever, man. What he means is we've been around since like roughly August or September of 2013, which is like the start of our freshman year.
Yep. It was like almost 2 years ago. Don't take it from me.
All right, and finally, what are some of your musical influences?
Influences. I look back and I recall upon the early bands in the 60s and 70s, like, you know, Aerosmith and the Beatles and Camden himself.
Oh, that's so sweet. I mean, you get Van Halen, Led Zeppelin, and then you get punk music like Dead Kennedys, and then you get like metal bands like Death, Cannibal Corpse, Metallica, and then Alice in Chains, all brought in at the same time.
I like to listen to like drummer heavy bands like Rush, Flaming Lips, stuff such as that.
And like, I like to listen to bass heavy, because I'm the bassist, bass heavy bands such as Tame Impala and The Beatles. Those are my two favorite bands.
I don't know. I sort of just kind of draw on what I can from who I can. I don't know. No one specific.
He's a leech.
All right.
Leech. We have a leech.
And I think that concludes our interview.
Hi, guys. So up now we have 51st State. They started around 2 years ago, and they came to a conclusion that they love candlelit dinners and long walks on the beach. So give it up for 51st State.
We'll be right back.
you. We are 51st State. Hope you enjoy the rest of our set. That's David.
Hi, David.
He does guitar. That's Cam. He also does guitar, but like more. Same bad, gosh. That's Caitlin. She does bass. And that's Jeremy. He does good stuff, you know. I'm Jordan. I sing. Sometimes I play. You know, it depends on the day. All right.
Thank you.
We're so away, entire lifetime, but
space in my mind when she's not right there beside me. I'm running crazy, but she never knew where I want to be. So this is gonna be our last song, and I think we're just gonna go for it. All right. Whenever y'all are ready. Because you look so fine and I really wanna make you mine. Said you look so fine and I really wanna make you mine. Said 4, 5, 6, come on and get your chance. Cause you don't need the money when you look like that, you got it. I said, are you gonna be my girl? Said, 1, 2, 3, clap hands, call me, because you look so fine and I really wanna make you mine. You look so fine and I really wanna make you mine. 4, 5, 6, come on, wanna get your kiss, because you don't need your money when you look like that. Are you gonna be my girl?
right, I'm here with our next band. With the first question, what music do you guys like to listen to?
We're a metalcore band, so we pretty much love metalcore.
Yeah, that's all we really.
Yeah.
Some hardcore.
I like everything.
Yeah,
I honestly listen to everything.
Yeah, I like that. It's efficient. We're getting it done quickly. What inspired you guys to join a band?
Bands.
Yeah. Other bands.
Gage. I love music so much.
Yeah.
Gage.
Yeah. We got my buddy here, and it's been great.
Yeah, we've been playing music together since we were like 12, 13
years
old.
Yeah, it was bad.
So, kind of just did that.
Better now.
All right, and have you guys ever performed in public before?
Yeah, a few times. Here last year, the Palladium twice, a bunch of random places.
Yeah. Bunch of bars and stuff.
And how long have you guys been together?
September 26th,
2013,
so it's like coming on 2 years.
Right?
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah,
2 years, yeah. Yeah.
Something like that.
And then finally, like, what are your some of your musical influences?
Prada.
Prada. I really like Memphis Mayfire.
The Devil Wears Prada.
Amity Affliction. Really good.
For today.
Hey guys. So this is Moments, and they started in September 2012. So let's give them a hand.
All right, we're trying to squeeze 5 songs into this, so I'm not going to talk very much. Hey, have a good night, hey! Alright. Are you ready? This one's an original called Love and Glory.
one. Who else is that nice man? This one goes out to anybody who's ever lost someone in their life that meant the world to them. This one's called Second Sebring.
I made it.
regional manager, everybody. I just want to say all the bands were great. You guys were all awesome. Give it up for them all. Everyone. You
So I'm here with our final band, Valley's the Ceiling Fan. So the first question is for you guys, what music do you listen to?
I don't listen to music.
It's not really my thing, but I like everything from punk to not punk.
Post-advent jazzcore, which I like better than progressive dream funk.
Progressive dream funk's the worst. A lot of Diarrhea Planet, because, you know, that really gets to my heart. I love Diarrhea Planet.
What inspired you guys to join a band?
These guys. Same.
Oh, that's so cute.
We were really lazy, and we started this a month ago, and we woke up one morning, and we were like, we need a band.
I'm not good at anything else. So
that's pretty much me too. This was
all right. All right.
We're not even good at this. We're just kind of.
We're just kind of.
Yeah, some winners over here. All right. Have you ever performed in public before? When and where?
Yes, and too many times to say.
Yes, in really horrible bands. So hopefully this won't be one of them.
Same with their answers, but we performed at Battle of the Bands before.
Yeah, this is like, I've never lost this, you know.
Wow. It is true.
He's very modest. First place every year.
Oh, crap.
All right.
Someone knock on that.
And what are some of your musical influences?
Diarrhea Planet.
All right.
Just skip.
My favorite band is Green Day.
Here, I'll come back to me. I need to think about it.
Yeah, I got it.
Do you really, though?
I think we've already, like, that was the first question.
I don't know.
You're just asking us the same question.
I know.
Over again.
I really like
this interview's
Diarrhea weird. Planet.
I already said that. To wrap up
the night, we have Val Eats the Ceiling Fam. They started just about last month, and they are ironic.
I don't know if it's wrong. You play ironically.
Hey guys!
Thank you. shake, shake, shake.
This has been such a great success, and I love to see all your beautiful faces here. I also want to thank Savings Bank for sponsoring us. We couldn't have done this without them, so thank you. And I'm gonna announce the winner for People's Choice. They're receiving a $100 gift card to Guitar Center. So here we go. The winner is... Drum roll, please.
Well, they're all put away.
Welcome, Matt. Then the judge's choice is a $25 gift card for Guitar Center. Third place is Moments.
My name's Amy. I'm the Director of Youth Services for the town of North Reading, and I just want to say thank you guys for coming. A lot of what you saw tonight is the students in our programs plan it out, they set the rules, they make all the decisions. So I just want to thank all the volunteers in the room from North Reading Youth Services, from Rotary Clubs around our district, and also to the teenage volunteers in the room. So thank you very much. I've obviously been yelling a lot today. So I'm going to let Annie have the honors of announcing first place.
Second!
place. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Don't jump ahead. Okay. Second place is Veader.
I'm spending all this money myself. Nobody else gets it.
Wait, you guys need a picture.
Where's Kayla?
Oh, she's
here.
She's
right. Peter!
Oh, my gosh.
Okay. First place, judge's choice. It's 51st date. Tonight. Thank you guys so much. Thank you for everybody for coming. Drive home safely and have a great night.